All people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم، وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم، سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد. اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا، وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. الحمد لله الذي شرفنا بالإيمان والإسلام والإحسان، وجعلنا من أمة الحبيب المصطفى العدنان. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نشكره لما أعطانا هذا الدين، إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله، أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانًا وأفصحها بيانًا، فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده، خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. O Muslims, believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants something from us. That he likes. When Allah wants something, means he likes that thing. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want that thing, means he doesn't like that thing. Allah likes from the ummah something that is so easy but so precious. Allah knows what is in our heart. And those who are coming to Jum'ah, and those who are going to Masajid for their 5 prayers or 3 prayers or 2 prayers or 1 prayer, they are all showing one thing that Allah likes, is to make sajda. To make the sajda is forcing shaitan to run away. And in sajda, what you say, the sajda is a symbol of understanding the meaning that no one can bow or go on earth, putting his forehead on earth, on soil, except those who are believing in La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. It is said that Allah said, كُنْتُ كَنْزًا مَخْفِيًّا فَأَرَدْتُ أَنْ أُعْرَفْ فَخَلَقْتُ الْخَلْقِ فَبِهِ عَرَفُونِي. I was a hidden treasure, means I was not known. I didn't create any creation yet. But he wanted to be known. He wanted what he likes for himself, he wants from us to like it also. And what he likes to himself is to praise himself. Allah can praise himself. But the Ummah cannot pray themselves. They have to pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants us to praise him. He said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to the one, the creator, the one who created creation. كنت كنزا مخفيا فأردت أن أعرف فخلقت الخلق. I wanted to be known through, I like that, to be known I created creation. And I praised myself by saying الحمد لله رب العالمين. By saying سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. Praise be to the one who took his servant to Kawa Kausaini Aw Adna. Allah likes that. Likes the abbot who say La ilaha illallah. If you say La ilaha illallah 1 time or 100 times or 1,000,000 times, of course there is too many rewards for those who say more, but we will be under his rahmah. And what is his rahmah? The description of rahmah is what? First of all, description of rahmah is you are under his mercy. Anyone under his mercy, he will never see hellfire. When you say La ilaha illallah, how you are going to say La ilaha illallah and Allah will put you in hell? It's impossible. Even you do in between sins, but you are saying La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah waves everything. It waves kufr. It takes away kufr. Al-Islamu yajibbu ma qabla. Islam, when you say shahada or say la ilaha illallah, maqam al-tawheed, takes all sins. So if you say it, is a non-Muslim say it, it will waive his sins. What you think about a Muslim who believes in Allah, it will not waive his sin? Because it's Prophet said, Al-Islamu yajibbu ma qabla. Islam is La ilaha illallah. When you say La ilaha illallah, Allah forbid anyone to touch you. And Allah said that man qala La ilaha illallah, in the meaning of saying La ilaha illallah, as Prophet said, دخل الجنة. أفضل الذكر فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله, the best, the highest level of zikrullah. If you don't like that word zikrullah, because some people they say, oh, Allah mentioned it in Holy Quran many, many times. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned it in the hadith many, many times. And strong hadith, a hadith muttafaqun alayhi fiha. One of them, أَنَا جَلِيسُ مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي. Finish. If you say لا إله إلا الله now, Allah is saying in a holy hadith to Prophet, it's a revealed hadith, that I am with the one who remembers me, sitting with him. And you go and make a sin, it will be written a sin. إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. Allah said in Holy Quran, that is a hasana when you say لا إله إلا الله. Allah will say to you what? When you remember him through كلمة التوحيد لا إله إلا الله, Allah will say to you what? I am with you. If Allah with us, what will happen with the sin? It will disappear. Allah doesn't like for his servant who says La ilaha illallah to be touched by hellfire. So say always, whenever you can, you say La ilaha illallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will waive your sins. Like kufr is being waived when you say la ilaha, when the convert say la ilaha illallah, the Muslim, his sins will not be waived. Because when we are doing a sin, is as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, akhwaf ma akhafu ala ummati ash-shirk al-khafi. The most I fear for my ummah, the hidden shirk, means when you commit a sin. So when you commit a sin, Allah is giving you something to say, to enter back to the circle of paradise. Because zikr circles are gardens of heavens. إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. If you pass by the gardens of heaven, sit with them. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ وَمَا رِيَاضُ الْجَنَّةِ قَالْ حِلَكُ الزِّكْرِ. What are these gardens of paradise? And Prophet said, the circles of zikrullah. So do yourself, your heart, your head, your mind, your feet, your hands, your organs, gardens of heavens, by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah remember us, but He wants us to remember Him. And will he will give us ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. He will give you what no one knows. Not an eye has seen, not an ear has heard. Nothing can be resembled of what Allah will give you. The most important day in your life is not your birthday. They celebrate the birthday. Celebrate every moment, the death day, by zikrullah, because it will save you at the bed of death. Birthday is not going to save you at the day of birth, at the day of death. It will make you to make more sins, because in birthdays parties we know what will happen. But in death parties, also we know what will happen. One, all kind of bad things, and one is reminding you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is taking your soul. And Allah said to Prophet, and this is a hadith, a strong hadith from Bukhari and Muslim, سَبْعَةٌ يَضِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ تَحْتَ ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven people, seven group of people, seven different groups, Allah will, what? What? Shade is a wrong word for that. To have a shade, you have to have a body, to a form. So what kind then of shade Allah is giving is not shade that we are understanding, that a cloud will come and stop us between sun and us on earth. Everyone will, his brain will be burning from that heat of that sun. It's not going to be a cloud. What kind of, if you want to use the word shade, shade Allah will give to you. In the day of judgment. What is the best to be given to you? The best is to be with Him. Not uniting, as some ulama in the past came and they say, Wahdatul Wujud. We don't believe in Wahdatul Wujud. But Allah will give you something that you like. What you like most in your life. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. يا رب, give us in dunya حسنة and in the day of judgment حسنة, when you are going to judge us, and hide us and keep us away from hellfire. That حسنة, what is the ظل, is the رحمة. Is Sayyidina Muhammad عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام رحمة للعالمين, mercy for humanity. That ظل, that Prophet will take you under his arms. Allah gives him that permission to intercede for everyone. That ظل is the intercession of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم for the Ummah. And more than that, He will give you ma la'aynun ra'at, what an eye did not see, what an ear did not hear. You never imagine it. Allah will give you. When you say, Ya Rasul Allah, Allah is happy. Because this leads you to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. Allah made our prayer to be accepted. When we say in it, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. That for you, Ya Rabbi, Ya Allah, we are worshipping. And from you we are asking support. Allah likes that abd to say, I need you, Ya Rabbi. Not to say, I did that, I did that. No. Allah helped you to do the goodness. And shaitan helped you to do the bad. O Muslims, Allah will give us a shade. That shade is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To let you, مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Allah will put you with that group of prophets, of martyrs, of pious people, and sincere peoples. That's what that zul that has what Allah gave to Prophet, He will give to you. Az-zul is something that no one can understand how valuable it is. That's why he said, يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّ سَبْعَةٌ يَظُلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّ. At that day, there is no shade except his shade, means there is no rahmah except from him. There is no one to find that can save you. All prophets except Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be running with their nations for a shade, for a rahmah. To whom they run? According to hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to intercede for them. Prophets and their nations. So that zul is zul al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah will give him by permission, that intercession for him in the day of judgment. I judge between my servants, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. I, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Muhammad, I have judged between my servants. Who does good, did good, will take an atom of good, he will be rewarded for it. Who did something bad, he will be judged for it. This is the pen. My decision is being done. I'm giving it to you. You intercede for whom you like. What do you think Prophet is going to do? You are the people who are sitting in gardens of heavens. As Prophet said, those Muslims around the world that they are sitting and praying and praising and making zikrullah and teaching Quran, Hadith, Fiqh. What they are going to get? Nothing. In dunya they get some money. It's okay. But in akhirah, they will take intercession from Prophet ﷺ. Be like these people. And the first one that is being mentioned, that he will be rewarded from that shade that we are discussing is Imam Adil. He didn't say Imam. Because you can be an Imam and you are not just Adil. He said Imam Adil. There is a condition for an Imam. And we leave this for next week. Inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and support us to keep us مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيق. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين. أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد. يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز كلمة هذا الدين واشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين بجاه حبيبك المصطفى، وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.
سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة.